It's Pig Heart Week on the King of Random. Hey, what's up, guys? In this video, we're carrying on with the heart theme. Now, in a previous video, I took a pig heart, cast it in silicone, and turned it into an edible chocolate heart for Valentine's Day. And I was gonna take the original pig heart that came out of the silicone mold and freeze it in liquid nitrogen so we could chip away at it. But a lot of you in the comments have been asking to put the pig heart in a vacuum chamber first. So for this video, we're gonna try just that. We're gonna answer the question, what does a heart do in a vacuum chamber? See, from this direction, it actually does look a little more like a heart. Like, you got the actual heart shape there.
Very peculiar.
Now, at first I thought this was gonna be kind of a lame experiment because the heart's just a giant muscle. And putting this in a vacuum chamber, I wouldn't really expect much to happen at all. So now's the time that we can make our predictions about what you think is going to happen. Is anything gonna happen at all? Or is this heart just gonna sit there and do absolutely nothing? I'm gonna like stick my finger down inside there. Whatever this little flappy thing on top is got cut, apparently. And it's got little tubes in there. There's actually a lot of little tubes. I guess that's a question, is the tissue airtight? Or will the air just suck right out of it? There's only one way to find out exactly what's gonna happen, and that's to plop this thing in and start drawing a vacuum. I'm gonna buff this thing up a little bit so we get a nice clear view down inside, and I'm using the glass jar so we can see inside from every different angle as well. Beautiful, that's looking good. So we've got our jar of heart.
Collecting your jar of hearts.
What's gonna happen? Is anything gonna happen? There's only one way to find out. Gauges are set, valves are closed. Here we go. Okay, we're already at 25 inches of mercury. That sucked up really fast. And it's hard to tell, but I can't really notice any visible change in the heart. I can't even see if it got bigger or not. It looks completely the same to me from every angle. 26 and a half inches of mercury. That's as much as this vacuum chamber can pull. Yeah, interesting. It doesn't really appear to be doing anything. It's just kind of sitting there. I was afraid that might happen. So I think what we're gonna have to do is release the pressure and see what happens to it. Will it deflate as we do? Okay, first release. Oh yeah, the heart did deflate a little bit. So there was a little bit of a difference that I noticed. Like, the surface of the heart appeared to be kind of inflated like a balloon a little bit. It wasn't really a lot, but just the skin seemed to be puffed out a bit. When we let the air back in, it sucked back in, so you could see the valleys in those veins. I'm gonna pump it up one more time and just watch those veins to see if that's really the case. Now we can focus on the veins down here near the bottom of the heart. Watch what happens when I open the valve and let the air back in. Yeah, that's about as good as it gets under vacuum, I suppose. So yeah, that was a little bit anticlimactic. Nothing really seems to be happening with the heart itself under vacuum. Small changes, but nothing much. So I thought just for fun, let's pour in a glass of water, see how the heart and water react together in the vacuum chamber. This water is aerated as well, so it should have some more bubbles in it. I'm wondering if I can open up one of these valves and just like pour some water into it. Perfect. Okay, let's see if anything cooler happens this time. Here we go. Oh, you can see all the bubbles coming out of the water. This water was aerated, and so now you can see all the bubbles are being pulled out of it. That's really cool. That's really cool. So I know water boils in a vacuum, but at this point, I think it's just pulling all the air out of the water first. Okay, now let's let the pressure back in. Nice. Nice little spray of water there. That's kind of fun. So at this point, I think what I'm gonna do is just fill up the entire jar with aerated water, get a bunch of bubbling going on just so it looks cool. We'll give it kind of like a mad science feel, if you will. Lid goes on, valves are closed, ready to rock. You can see how cloudy the water is, and almost immediately it starts rushing toward the top and clears right up. That's probably the coolest thing about this experiment so far. While we're here, let's get a thumbnail. There we go. Okay, well, water in a heart in a vacuum chamber is a little bit more exciting. All right, here we go. That has had enough time. Let's go ahead and release it. Nice. All right, so water and a heart in a vacuum chamber is a little more exciting, but not exciting enough. So I have one more idea, and it involves this chocolate heart that we made in another video. Let's go ahead and melt this thing down, pour it into the vacuum chamber, and see what chocolate does. Very lovely. Getting some weird aromas going on here, like chocolate and pig heart. That's a weird combination. The king of random, where random is the norm. So our chocolate heart is melted down and nicely constituted. Let's just pour this into the vacuum chamber and see what chocolate will do. I also used an egg beater and I whipped a little more air into this just to make it a little bit more exciting. Should be fun. Like the chocolate's molding to the outside of the heart here. I don't know if that's cool or if that's disturbing. All right, this is our last experiment today, so my hopes are high for whipped chocolate. Here we go. Oh, wow. Oh my goodness, wow. Oh, that looks so cool. You know what's really weird about the color of that chocolate is it almost looks like blood red, like curdling blood around this little heart. Oh, you know what I just realized? This is gonna make one heck of a mess inside the vacuum chamber. It looks like it's alive. That's a little creepy. Okay. The chocolate's had a bit of time to cool, so let's go ahead and open this up and see what happens. It's cool how that fogs up. Insta-cloud. Oh, check this out, this is disgusting. The chocolate has solidified on the outside of the heart, and the rest of it on the inside. Some of it's liquid, some of it's solidified to the side, but that looks a little disturbing. So there you have it, guys. That's what happens when you put a pig heart into a vacuum chamber. Thanks again to Acid for requesting this experiment in the comments. Go ahead and check your inbox. I'll be sending you $25. And thanks again to all of you for hanging out with me today. I'll be looking for you in the next video. Talk to you then. I'm putting my heart into this project. I'm gonna go grab some safety glasses. Where did I even put my safety glasses?